So it's a very exciting time in Australia for marine reserves. The federal government, which started a process of building a big marine park system a long time ago, 1996, when we convinced Senator Robert Hill that we needed a big system of marine parks, and he started that process rolling. About 3 years ago, they rezoned a lot of the southeast of Australia. Now, of course, the area we're talking about is the size of Australia itself. The exclusive economic zone of Australia is 7 million square kilometres, and we're in the middle of rezoning it now as we speak. The southeast didn't really go so well. Only 8% of the southeast of Australia became a no-take zone, full marine sanctuary. And unfortunately, of the entire shelf areas, the areas that are most under threat from fishing and oil and gas extraction, only 0.5% of them were conserved. Just last week, just a few days ago, they released the first draft of the plan for the southwest of Australia. And this is an area from Adelaide, from about the middle of the bottom of the country, all the way to the middle of the western side of the country, 1 million square kilometres of sea. And they released plans for no-take zones there. Unfortunately, that plan again, although it looks good on paper, it's 22% of the region, it really misses the mark on this issue of representing all the habitat types properly. Only 3.5%, 3.5% of the shelf area, which is again the area where most of the fishing and most of the other resource use exists, only 3.5% of that is projected or planned to be in no-take zones, and that will be now out for consultation for the next 90 days. So it's an exciting time, it's a very important time for the people of Australia to decide, do they want a well-designed system of marine protected areas, or do they just want this one big park? We shouldn't also underestimate the value of this region of Australia. A lot of people around the world think Australia, marine parks, they think Great Barrier Reef, and of course we have a very good marine park system there. 33% of the Great Barrier Reef is conserved. And there, they really did meet the targets very well, because they, in that 33%, at least 20% of every kind of habitat's conserved. So it's a very even representation of habitat types. The irony is, the southwest of Western Australia is actually more unique than the Great Barrier Reef. Many, many more species, a much bigger fraction of the species, only occur in that part of the world. Many of the species in the Great Barrier Reef are shared with other countries to our north, Indonesia, the Solomon Islands, Papua New Guinea. So from a global perspective, in fact, even though the Great Barrier Reef gets all the glory in terms of Australian marine protected areas, this, from an international perspective, is far more important. There's blue whales, one of the few places where blue whales still feed in Australia. There's huge canyons. There's an enormous diversity of marine mammals and marine seabirds, there's turtles, and the diversity of things that people don't care often so much about, like algae, red algae, is amazing. There's hundreds of species that occur nowhere else on the planet, and unfortunately this plan doesn't protect them as well as it might. Well, in terms of science, they have used the software, they've used enormous amounts of data. They had data on 2,000 different types of organism. They also had data on 50 different kinds of industry, fishing, transport industries that use this area. So all those things were wrapped up in our software, and the intent of that software is to again try and conserve a representative sample of all the kinds of diversity, probably at least 20% of every kind of diversity, every kind of habitat, every kind of species, and in doing so try and avoid conflict with industry. It's that second statement they seem to have taken a little bit too seriously. They've avoided it so much that they've missed out on the scientific goals, which we have a consensus statement of Australian marine scientists that said you need representative reserve systems and you need to target a certain fraction of all those in a very equitable and even fashion. And unfortunately, in that case, they seem to have been rolled by the industry, both fishing and mining.